Yeah, good morning, everybody. Welcome to Unity of Tulsa Midtown. My name is Amanda Preslar. I'm joined on stage with some fabulous musicians, and for those online, I'm joined with an incredible congregation as well. We welcome you to our service here at Unity of Tulsa Midtown. It's a special day today. I'm so excited about it. We'll talk about that here in just a second, but let's open up the service. Would you stand with me and sing? It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day.
Welcome you this morning to Unity of Tulsa Midtown, where we like to say, no matter who you are or where you are on your spiritual path, you are welcome here. And we've got a great whole day planned for you. But before I announce and talk about that, first of all, we have connect cards in the pews, and I invite you to fill one out. And the purpose of this card is to give us information so that we can put you on the email list so that you can get our weekly pathways, which is a weekly newsletter that we send out every Thursday morning. And that lets you know what's going on. So if you would be so kind to do that. And then also there is a place for you to check if you would like to request prayer. And then that way, Reverend Shanna then can reach out to you and speak to you about your request. And then you'll notice in your flyer that you got another, the second week, for an evaluation sheet. And that is because this Sunday, our second ministerial candidate, Reverend Shanna Warner, is with us today, and she will be speaking. Woo-hoo! So you can fill this out during the service. It looks like Pat's here, Cheryl's here, so they'll collect these from you at the end of the service. So to get to our announcements, and we do have a lot, like I said, Reverend Shanna is with us, and her message title today is Step into the Allowing, 40 Days of Letting Go. Wednesday starts Lent. Can you guys believe that? Wednesday starts is the beginning of Lent. The Bible class Saturday that we had with Reverend Chaz was a huge success. It was very well attended, and we will be having the second class for that next Saturday. So I know some of you wanted to come and couldn't come, and so hopefully you'll be able to join us in that class. And he's going to talk about divine love in that class. Please, please, please fill out your membership card. We failed to get them mailed out to you, so it's very important that you fill out the membership card for the renewal of your membership. Not if you have not attended a Unity membership orientation class, you must do that, and we just had that. So it's for the renewal of your membership. Unity Luncheon is February the 23rd. I believe we're going to Applebee's, and so if you would please let Maggie know so that oh, that's okay. Emma Kate, I forget what Emma Kate, what's your dog's name? Ripley. That's okay, Ripley. Ripley must like Applebee's. But let Maggie know, okay? Next Sunday is our Sacred Soul service that Sharla and Ben lead. So we'll want to invite you to be here at 6 p.m. on Sunday for that. Next Sunday is our annual membership meeting as well. So right after the service, we'll have, again, another little light lunch, and then we'll all come back into the sanctuary, and we'll have our annual meeting then. And I want to thank the two people that signed up for the nursery help, but we need a lot more, okay? So be brave. You only have to do it once a month or maybe once every 6 weeks as more and more people sign up. But please, please do that because Jessica needs the help. So, as we bring ourselves collectively together and we begin our service of prayer and meditation, we always begin our service with the reading from the Daily Word, as every Unity Church does. So I like to think of the energy that, you know, we're all coming together and reading that same daily word. And I want to invite Renny up today to read the daily word for us. Welcome home, Renny.
Yes.
I aspire to help create a world that works for all. I hold a vision of an equitable world, a global community that supports and encourages all people to live fully and reach their unique potential. I feel a kinship with those who hold a similar vision and work to realize it. My past experiences and present perspective show me what is mine to do and how I can contribute to realizing my vision. I trust I will be guided and inspired to find avenues of service where the things I do best and enjoy most doing will be the most helpful. I bless people I may have never met, and I offer my time, talents, and effort to further my vision of a new way of living. With clarity of purpose, I take my place among a growing network of caring, visionary souls. Our scripture reading today is from Ephesians chapter 4, verses 11 and 12. The gifts he gave were to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ. I aspire to help create a world that works for all. Thank you, God. Amen.
And now as we bring our focus to our prayer box and we join our hearts and minds together, because we are gathered today here in community to lovingly acknowledge each slip of paper that goes into this prayer box. This prayer box every Wednesday at noon is taken into the prayer chapel and prayed upon and meditated upon. Each Sunday, we bring it into the service so that we can collectively pray together. So let us pray. Father, Mother, Creator, each request in our prayer box is dear to us as a community. We ask for healing, for abundance, for spiritual guidance, for mended hearts and families. And we affirm our divine connection as a community and with you. May we be focused on seeing the best in one another. May we give grace, charity, and love to those little perceived offenses. And may we offer forgiveness to ourselves and to others in the knowledge that forgiveness brings a divine healing touch to every situation. May we be focused on creating love and kindness in our own hearts so that we create the same in the external world. And it is with hearts full of joy that we bring our thanks to you. Amen.
Different than any you have known. It's all about allowing change to
song so much. Thank you guys. So let's begin that process of stepping into the allowing. Will you allow me right now to share some words with you as we enter a time of meditation together? So, you know, I often write meditations because it's something I love to do, but I found a prayer that just really struck me, and I want to share this with you. This was written by an attorney friend. So what I'd like you to do is take a deep breath. And as you let that out, just let your shoulders relax. Let your body relax and listen to these words. Allow these words to sink into your heart. Don't worry, it's going to be okay. It's all right, little one. You're safe and loved. It's okay to cry. It's okay to be afraid. It's okay to be weak. It's okay to be vulnerable. It's okay to be human. It's from all these elements that we grow, and it's from all these elements that I am born out of you. I love you. You're not alone. So long as you reach out to others, you're never alone. Ask for my help in loaning you the courage you already have. It's not that I never give you more than you can handle. I am not responsible for the consequences of your actions, only you are. Stay on the path of your suffering by taking the steps you need to take. Hang on and hang in there, because it's now that you're growing at light speed. You're never going backward, only forward. Decay your loneliness by making full use of my greatest gift to mankind, which is mankind. Feel my alleged absence as proof for the paradox that I exist and have always existed. Let me in by letting me out. Love, fear, and all of the other feelings spored are what create this reality. These are the cause and effect of compassion and true forgiveness ask for my help in walking through the anguish of forgiveness. Do everything in your power to learn to forgive and love those that hurt you, not for just them, but for others as well as yourself. And never give up the hope that someday your ex-suffering will be able to help the ones who were sick and hurt you, as well as those who suffered like you. Learn all this by practicing to love everyone. Always look into yourself first, your past, your present, your motives, your feelings, and share the secrets you find with me as well as others. Be gentle and kind to yourself by being vulnerable and sharing yourself with others who are also patient, kind, and who can only try to love and accept you as much as I do. And as you get better at this, take the risks that will enable you to venture out further and further so that your true self may finally be exposed to the real world I created for you to live in. Free yourself with the truth. If you can learn to love, forgive, fully listen, understand, and accept those around you, you will eventually begin to learn how to love, forgive, fully listen, understand, and accept yourself. Let me in, little one, by letting me out. I love you. You are never alone. And allow those words to sink in. Breathe in deeply again. And breathe out. And know that we are never, never alone. I just took somebody else's notes.
sanctuary. We won't let it die. All that you have dreamed for, we'll watch it come alive. So brother, don't you worry, we won't let it die. All that you
congregation. Let's stand up. Let's stand. We're going to do some affirmations. We'll see what comes on the screen. We've got our vision statement. Let's state this together. Centered in the divine, we celebrate a world of peace, harmony, and love. And we've got one more. Our mission. Let's say this together also. We look within to awaken our souls by discovering and sharing divine love. Okay, stretch. Feel good. You guys can have a seat. I'm going to wet my whistle here just for a second. Not that I'm going to whistle. So, yeah, I want to tell you how conversations go in my house. So, when I told Mark what I was speaking, that I was speaking today about Lent, he asked me why I'm talking about our dryer. Right, so he always gives me something to laugh about when I'm really, really serious. And I'm pretty often serious, and I give him serious moments as often as I can. So today we are not talking about belly button lint or anything that comes out of the dryer. We're talking about Lent of a different kind, L-E-N-T. In the church, it's that period of reflection, 40 days, for preparation for Easter. So that's what we're going to talk about today. And that starts this Wednesday. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in a bit because I want to talk a little bit about gardening and how much I love that song, This Garden's Gonna Grow. You know, I love the idea of gardening, although I don't really have a green thumb. You know, allowing the mystery of nature to do its thing. My friend Gina is a great gardener. She's a great seamstress, too. But she's a fabulous gardener. She has two green thumbs. So I can keep some houseplants alive. But when I look outside in my yard, I get a little bit overwhelmed with the idea of, oh, my gosh, what am I going to put there? And, you know, what? Oh, my gosh, can I do this? So Gina tells me that it's about letting plants be where they want to be. The plant will let you know when it's happy or when it's not. If it's not growing well, we'll move it. You know, we're going to put that plant over here, and then it gets happy. We have to let that plant tell us. You know, that's kind of this holistic way of looking at gardening. Her yard looks like a jungle. I look at it and see chaos. But she looks at it and she laughs and she says, well, it's because they're happy. They're happy plants. And she gets excited, you know, this time of year, because even in winter, we're still in winter, we're not in spring. Even in winter, she will see little shoots and little bits of greenery. And she's just telling me this is happy because this garden's going to grow, right? That's a perfect metaphor for us spiritually, isn't it? Right? That even in the depth of winter, and I don't just mean the physical winter of the earth, I mean the winter of our soul, even in the depths of the winter, this garden can grow. It's still there, that bud is there. Isn't that mystical statement of our spirituality? Of course, when I also look at Gina's yard, in all that chaos, there aren't any weeds. So she shared a gardening tip with me. Are there any other gardeners out here? Anybody else loves gardening? Okay. I've got projects at my house. Y'all can come help me. So here's Gina's gardening tip. She says, here's the thing. When plants are happy and they're healthy and they're flourishing, they're getting the sunlight and the water and the nutrients that they need, there's no room for weeds, right? There's no room for the weeds. That's like the parable of the sower that Jesus taught. In Matthew 15, Jesus is on vacation. Well, actually, the Bible doesn't say he's on vacation, but it says he went to the seaside. Maybe it wasn't a vacation, but he did go boating quite a bit on the Sea of Galilee. Right? Maybe there was some sort of skiing involved. I don't know. Anyway, people followed him wherever he was. You know, and in the midst of his ministry, people followed him, crowds. So he got into a little boat, got out into the sea, and shared some stories, and this is the one he shared. A farmer went out to sow his seed. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plants were scorched, and they withered because they had no roots. Other seed fell among thorns, which grew up and choked the plants. Still other seed fell on good soil where it produced a crop, 100, 60, or 30 times what was sown, and whoever has ears, let them hear. As you plant seeds in your life and in the lives of others, some of it won't grow. There are always birds of negativity on the pathway to gobble it up. Let that go, right? The birds are always pecking at something. Let that negativity go. We all experience weeds in our life from sometimes negative people or negative situations, right? They try to choke out the growth. Let that go, right? Ignore that too. Jesus talked about two different types of soil, shallow soil and deep soil. The seeds might get a quick growth in the shallow soil, but as soon as problems come along in our life, if that soil's not deep, what happens? We get burned. Those little plants burn. It's the deep, fertile soil that the seeds can really grow in. So the question we need to really ask is, how do we create deep and fertile soil? How, right? Isn't that our question? How do we do that? Okay, we want to do that. How do we do that? And that's why I say it's about allowing spirit to do its thing. This is stepping into the allowing. So I don't know if you caught all the beautiful lyrics of that song earlier. I'm going to set my water right there. It's all about allowing peace within, in absolute surrender, so serenity begins. For when the storm subsided and calm becomes the way, it's all about allowing it to stay. It's all about allowing love to flow. It's setting down your burdens and just simply letting go. For as you cease the struggle and love pours through your heart, it's all about allowing it to start. So we're talking about stepping into the process of allowing.
building that fertile and deep soil so that we can grow spiritually. And we have a way. And in unity, that's our five basic principles. So number one says there's only one presence, one good in the universe, and it is God. And it's pure good. We call it God. Others may call it by another name, and that's okay too, because it's all the same presence. Number two, our spiritual essence, mine, yours, everyone's essence, spiritual essence is the same. We are also of that spiritual essence, and so therefore we are also good, and we see this pure goodness in the form of Christ, in Jesus. Number three, we co-create with God. We create the reality that's around us by connecting with the divine mind that we share. Number four, here's where we go. In prayer and meditation, we align our heart and mind with God. And number five, through our thoughts, words, and deeds, we live our beliefs. We don't just talk it, we walk it, right? Principle number four and five are part of the invitation that I have for you today. Prayer, meditation, walking the walk. Those are the ways that we're going to deepen our spiritual soil. And that is the allowing that I'm talking about. In 1661, the poet Isaac Pennington described this process of allowing in this way. And I love this poem. Give over thine own willing, give over thine own running, give over thine own desiring to know or to be anything, and sink down to the seed which God sows in the heart, and let that grow in thee, and be in thee, and breathe in thee, and act in thee, and thou shalt find by sweet experience that the Lord knows that, and loves that, and owns that, and will lead it to the inheritance of life, which is its portion. Wow. Now, how's that for a gorgeous statement of allowing? So, over the next 40 days, I have an invitation. I want you to step into something beautiful with me. And by the way, 40 is not a random number. 40 is a power number in ancient numerology and Kabbalistic lore. Therefore, it's in the Bible. The number 40 is the process, the number of restoration. It's the number of spiritual growth. It's no accident that Noah and the ark and the rain for 40 days and 40 nights and washed away the evil or the negativity, and there was time for new growth. Moses was on Mount Sinai for 40 days and came down, you know, with the spiritual law, you know. The Jews arrived at Mount Sinai as Egyptian slaves, and they wandered around not 40 days, but 40 years in the wilderness before they got to the promised land. Jesus spent 40 days meditating and fasting after he was baptized and started his ministry. Although I do want to mention that not all new ministers have to do that, just saying. There were 40 days between the resurrection of Christ and his full return to the spiritual realm. So 40 days, it's important. And my high school English teacher, Mrs. Laurita Quaid, told us that it takes 40 days to get rid of a bad habit and start a new one. So beginning this week, on Wednesday, and for the next 40 days until Easter, we have a guidebook. This guidebook comes from Unity. It's full of daily meditations that help us in the process of letting go. We have about 20 of these booklets up here at the front by the prayer box, and you are welcome to come get a printed version. They are free from Unity. You can go to unity.org and order one. You can also download a digital version and follow along on your phone or on your tablet. This is the, that's the link. You're welcome to take a picture of it. Or you can just go to unity.org. That might be easier, but there is a link. You can go download it. So, as we head into spring, you may be the sort of person that cleans out your closets. If you're the sort of person that gardens and cleans out closets, I especially want to talk to you. Spring cleaning, you know, after the dark days of winter, we're all ready for that promise of spring, you know, the promise of something new. It's the same spiritually. We clean out our spiritual closets too, right? Or we should. That's what the parable of the sower is all about, removing the weeds that come up in our life where the seeds can't grow, and instead developing that deep soil. There's a verse in a camp song that I learned when I was a child, and it goes like this, and I won't sing it for you, although I could. What a wondrous time is spring, when all the trees are budding, the birds begin to sing, the flowers start their blooming. That's how it is with God's love. Once you experience it, you want to sing, it's fresh like spring. You want to pass it on. And as we grow individually and collectively, we share that love, we share that experience, we share that process. We say, hey, you can do this, we can do this, we can grow spiritually. Hidden in every little bud, like Gina taught me, is the promise of that flower. It's there all along. The beautiful green essence is there. It's there in each and every one of us. That's us spiritually. Spring is our story. Easter is our story. It's the story of rebirth and renewal. That's what we're headed into in the next 40 days. We experience the human condition, loss and darkness, in some way every day, as a part of the human condition. Sometimes we get stuck in it, right? Have you ever gotten stuck in a dark place? In your mind, in your heart, in your life, in your job, in your relationship? We all get stuck sometimes. We long for the new life. We long for something beyond the winter of the soul. And Lent is about that process of letting go. Consciously letting go. Letting go of the things that cause us harm. Letting go, whether it's a little nagging worry or it's a big nagging worry, letting go. Sometimes we don't have choices about letting go. Sometimes things are taken from us. Death of family members, change in a job, difficult things that happen. Sometimes we don't have that choice in letting go. Sometimes the birds take the seed or the weeds choke things out. But we can let go of our fears and our worry about life and death and the process and allow our true spiritual reality to blossom. Because there's always a spiritual resurrection available to us. Always. It's that little bud that holds the promise of the flower. And after the dark, there's always the light. After the night, there's always the day. Every morning, a new and fresh way to begin. The sun sets, but the sun also rises. So Reverend Ellen Debenport, who is the vice president at Unity World Headquarters, explains Lent and Easter this way. Life is eternal, far beyond this physical existence. In the Unity tradition, resurrection is Jesus' final teaching for us. The risen Jesus says, there's so much more to life than you've realized. He puts divinity within our grasp. It lets us know that we can survive anything, literally anything, because we still always keep living in one form or another. We are the energy of life because we are part of one eternal presence and power in the entire universe. Now, some of you are already accustomed to joining with me on Wednesdays at noon. You hear the tornado siren, and I've heard from some of you that you join with me at noon, just even if it's for a moment, to align your mind as I sit in the meditation room with our prayer box and meditate. So every Wednesday at noon, I'm there. And starting this Wednesday, I will be using this little guidebook. And I invite you to choose a time every day, whether it's at noon, and sometimes you may not be able to join me at noon, but maybe 10 o'clock, maybe right before you go to bed, maybe right when you get up in the morning. Whenever you can, find a time every day. That's that deep and fertile soil, that practice of creating consciously. So you may have seen one of my favorite sayings up on the screen. We're going to have it up here. It goes, your mind is a garden. Your thoughts are the seeds. You can grow flowers or you can grow weeds, right? Consciously choosing to make time for prayer and meditation is putting Unity Principle number 4 into action, which is part of Unity Principle number 5, taking action. My granny, Clara McBride, a great Irish lass, used to say it this way, oh honey, you gotta put boots to your prayers, right? Is that some wisdom from a granny? Put boots to your prayers. If you truly want a deeper and more satisfying spiritual connection, then work it, baby, work it. You got to till the soil. You've got to plant flowers It's not weeds. You've got to let seeds that are planted in you blossom, and it will be beautiful to behold. So, throughout the 40 days, here are some of the things we're going to let go of. You let me know if any of these are something you want to let go of. Let's see. We're going to let go of anger, anxiety, apathy, bitterness, blame, busyness, chaos, competitiveness, complaining, criticism, darkness, discontent, discouragement, doubt, drama, fear of being alone, fear of change, fear of illness, fear of lack, indecision, insecurity, judgment, limitation, negative thinking, obligation, outdated beliefs, overwhelm, the past, perfectionism, pessimism, resentment, resistance, self-pity, shame, sorrow, stress, struggle, worry. Any of that you want to let go of? Right? Right? Any of that? Totally, me too. I want to let go of those things too. And I'll tell you what, the process, like the Grow song said, sometimes you may think it's slow. But I'll tell you what, letting go of any of those things is progress, even one. One step at a time. That's how we grow. Finally, as I finish up today, I want to share with you the wisdom of two great hearts. One of them is Mr. Rogers. And yes, that Mr. Rogers of the neighborhood. And the other is Helen Schuckman, the scribe of A Course in Miracles. And here's what Fred Rogers says. At the center of the universe is a loving heart that continues to beat and that wants the best for every person. Anything we can do to help foster the intellect and spirit and emotional growth of our fellow human beings, that is our job. Those of us who have this particular vision must continue against all odds. Life is for service. And Helen Schuckman recorded these words that were given to her. I am here only to be truly helpful. I'm here to represent him who sent me. I don't have to worry about what to say or what to do, because he who sent me will direct me. I'm content to be wherever he wishes, knowing he goes there with me. I will be healed as I let him teach me to heal. I'm here to plant seeds. Sowing the seeds of love. You know, that was a great song from the 80s, wasn't it? We're here to sow seeds of love, of fun, of community, of happiness, of joy together. We're here, all of us as gardeners, right? We're here to sow those spiritual seeds during chili and movie night, during chocolate auctions for the youth, which if you missed it, we had a blast. Thank you, Barbara and Lori. Thank you, ladies. We had a great time. We're here to sow seeds during Bible class and A Course in Miracles, and we're here to sow seeds during funerals and weddings, you know? We're here to sow seeds over coffee klatch, you know, in Neil Hall, and sow seeds in the prayer and meditation room. We're here to sow seeds in counseling and talking and love and laughter. So, how about you? Are you green? Are you? You are. Are you open to your own divine wisdom and beauty inside? I want to plant seeds here, in this church, this town, this state, this here and now. And I hope you do too, because I want us to grow together. Because I know this, God is good all the time. And so it is.
Well, we're going to get some more verbiage about that garden is going to grow. Because I remember about a year and a half ago, I got a phone call from Amanda. She said, oh, I found this song. I really like this song. I want you to listen to it. It's Garden is Going to Grow. And about a year and a half ago, we played this song. And I don't know if some of you remember that or not. But I can tell you when we played that song the first time, we had maybe 15 people in our congregation. And she and I and Renny You know, the team, we get so excited, we get so inspired, and the garden is going to grow. And look, I want you to look around. I want you to say hello, wave at somebody across the aisle, because our garden is growing.
Yes,
yes indeed. Thank you. So now is the time in our service when we receive our offering. So I'd like to invite our ushers to come forward, please. We want to acknowledge those who give online. Thank you very much. If you choose to mail your donation in, that's fine too. If you want to use our little barcode now that's on the back of your flyer, that's great too. We appreciate you so much. So for those of you here in the sanctuary, if you'd like to hold your gift in your hand and let us acknowledge together. Divine love, as me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. For so it is. Amen.
Thank you.
guys get the theme? Can you hear the theme going on today? Good. So if our ushers would come forward, please. We've each given individually or as an individual family. So now it's time to receive this gift as a spiritual community. So I invite you to pray with me. Dear God, we join together in gratefully receiving this offering of love. We bless it and we see it multiplied as it goes forth to accomplish our mission of changing lives. And we know that Spirit is the source of all that we receive and all we accomplish. And we say, thank you, God. Amen. And I believe we have children.
We are walking in the light, in the light, in the light. We are walking in the light of God. In the light, 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 in the light of God.
Jessica, you had a room full today. Welcome, kids. Hi, Rachel, good to see you. Well, I was saving this announcement till the end when Jessica was here because I don't think she's heard the final tally, but yes, Lori Morgan, is Lori here today? Oh, there she is, and Barbara. They put on a beautiful, beautiful Valentine's program and it was such a success. And our very own John Rainey now has a new title. It's called Chocolate Auctioneer. He did great. And so I'm happy to announce, Jessica, we raised $500.
Oh, wow. Thanks.
Yes, so that money is going towards the YOU rally that happens sometime in June, July, something like that. June. So the teenagers and Jessica go to this rally, and they've done it now for 2 years, and it's such a blessing to those kids. So, yay, that's exciting. So let us bless our kids. And I love it when the parents share little stories with us. And so Zachary here, he has his mom sometimes. He will request that she pull us up on YouTube so he can hear the music because he likes our music. And then she told me the other day he was singing, "Let There Be Peace on Earth." So let us stand. And we'll do the, are we going to do the medley or just whatever?
We're going to do something else first.
Oh, okay.
A little birdie told me, a little birdie named Renny told me it was Jessica's birthday. So let's all sing together. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Much for your diligence in being here every Sunday.
Yes.
For 18 years,
wow.
People. 18 years. Okay.
Now let's sing together.
We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones who make a brighter. Just you and me.
sing the peace song together.
Protection. Divine, the light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. So please join us in Neil Hall for the question and answer time with Reverend Shanna. Pat Reynolds and Cheryl and Renny are there to collect your evaluation sheets. And let's have a glorious day today.
That's right.
Thank you.
Let's do.
bright, sunshiny day.
What do you... Oh, Ann. While I was talking.
Like a dog.